Hip and knee replacements are the most common surgeries for Medicare beneficiaries. These surgeries combined cost Medicare more than $7 billion a year. As technology advances, more and more people are opting for hip and knee replacements, but the cost and quality of these surgeries varies greatly across the country. To address the high cost of hip and knee replacements and to improve the quality of care for patients, the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services, or CMS, is testing out an innovative alternative payment model. In 2016, the Innovation Center at CMS launched the Comprehensive Care for Joint Replacement model, also known as the CJR model. This model builds off the success of the prior Bundled Payments for Care Improvement initiative. In order to test whether this payment model works in diverse hospitals and communities, 378 hospitals in 34 randomly selected areas were required to participate. The model requires hospitals to focus on two things: reduce overall hip and knee replacement costs and improve the quality of care by implementing a more collaborative approach with physicians, post-acute care providers, and other clinicians. The CJR model holds these participating hospitals financially accountable for the cost and quality of each hip and knee replacement episode. An episode begins when the patient is hospitalized for the surgery and ends 90 days after the patient is discharged. This model encourages hospitals to pay attention to what happens after patients leave the hospital. This is important because following up with patients and improving care coordination may decrease complications that lead to costly readmissions. Patients are more likely to have a safe, positive experience and recovery. Let's take a look at how the model works. CMS provides hospitals with an average spending target for the cost of the surgery and healthcare services for the following 90 days. Hospitals can earn money if Medicare payments are below the target price and they meet CMS quality standards. Beginning in the second year of the model, hospitals are required to repay Medicare if the payments exceed the target price. Since launching the CJR model in 2016, the results have been promising. While fee-for-service payments for hip and knee replacement surgeries are decreasing in general, the CJR participant hospitals had larger reductions in fee-for-service payments than hospitals that were not in the model. CJR participant hospitals were able to reduce Medicare payments by 4.7% or over $1,300 per episode more than comparison hospitals, and the majority of these hospitals earned money during the first 3 years of the model. These payment reductions are largely driven by how patients receive care after they leave the hospital. Because of the CJR model, more patients are being discharged to home instead of going to a rehabilitation facility. Even though patients are receiving less intensive therapy, we found that quality of care is improving or remaining the same. And notably, readmission and complication rates decreased for patients at CJR participant hospitals. The introduction of this model is leading to greater systematic change, and hospitals are starting to design their care pathways around the CJR model goals. Many hospitals share that they are motivated to make changes to prepare for future episode-based payment models, and they are implementing strategies to improve the patient experience and provide more efficient care. These strategies include using data to track improvement. Looking at the data was eye-opening for many. Hospitals reported that sharing performance data was a critical strategy for engaging physicians in activities related to the model. According to one participating hospital, sharing data was very helpful in showing the surgeons inconsistency in care and impacts on cost, which pushed the conversation with the orthopedic group and helped them make that happen internally. Setting discharge expectations. Hospitals are beginning discharge planning earlier and educating patients about the benefits of going directly home instead of to a rehabilitation facility. Once patients learn that they are more likely to have better outcomes and less likely to experience complications, many prefer to recover at home. Some hospitals are even expanding their programs. One told CMS that, if pre-surgical education is such a valuable thing, why give it only to Medicare patients? We opened it up to all of our patients because every patient deserves to have the comfort level to make sure their experience is good. Coordination is key. Many hospitals now have care coordinators that guide patients through the entire process. Coordinators even check in after patients leave the hospital. Having someone to call directly about questions and concerns makes a big difference for patients and can help avoid unnecessary readmissions. A participating hospital shared that CJR has taken us from working in silos to looking at the bigger picture of pre-op and post-discharge. The CJR model showed that a mandatory episode-based payment model works well with a diverse range of hospitals with varying resources and circumstances. All different types of hospitals can lower payments for hip and knee replacement surgeries while supporting patients to go home earlier than before and preserving a high standard of quality of care. Interested in learning more? Visit the CMS Innovation Center website at innovation.cms.gov, where you can access the full third-year evaluation report and a summary of the findings on the Data and Reports webpage. Clinicians can check out the in-depth look section that profiles hospitals and associated providers. And researchers can see the comprehensive appendix for evaluation methods. Follow us on Twitter to stay up to date on how CMS is innovating healthcare.